now never lingers very long. As soon as we talk about now, it's already in the past. And so the present quickly becomes the past, even as we look forward to the moments that lie in the future. And the future always marches backwards toward the present in this never-ending march. It's also true that every moment of every day is substantively the same. There is no moment of time that is fundamentally different than any other moment in time. On Saturday, Cheryl and I celebrated our 35th wedding anniversary, and at its core, that day was really no different than any other day. And yet we marked it as a moment in time for reflection and celebration and thanksgiving. Today is sort of like that. It's a day like any other day. And yet, there's all kinds of celebrations going on this evening. Yeah. We mark it as something unique and special. It's this moment in time that stands at the end of one year, and we stand in the doorway, the threshold, if you will, looking into a brand new year. And so we mark these moments in time with both celebration and reflection. This morning I want to take a little time to do some of that reflection intentionally and purposefully. The Christian faith is one where we take moments in time to reflect. We think about what is old and the promises of God for what might be new. We look back to see where we have failed, and we look forward to see how God might yet work in our lives. The Jesuits have a spiritual practice that they call examen, and it simply comes from the Latin word to look at yourself. And the Jesuits practice this spirituality on a daily basis, where they spend some time at the end of every day reflecting on that day, and what has gone well, and what hasn't gone so well. And they reflect again on the next day, and what they hope might be better in the next day. We also have something similar ritually in our liturgy. Oftentimes we begin our liturgy with confession, where we look at our lives and what has been broken and where we have failed and ask for God's forgiveness. And so this morning, each of you, as I said, received one of those packets. I placed in the bulletin two envelopes and two sheets of paper, one blue and one white. And so right now I want you to take out the blue piece of paper. And I hope you can reach a hymnal someplace so that you can use the hymnal as a clipboard. A clipless clipboard, how's that? I want us to spend a few minutes individually, but also collectively, thinking about those things from the last year that you would like to leave behind. Old habits, old hurts, old ways of being, bitterness, whatever it is. I invite you to think especially about your relationship with God and your relationship with others, those around you. And let me give you the instructions now so you know what's going to happen. So I'm going to give you a few minutes. And I'd like you really to write down on those papers those things from the past year that you would like to leave behind. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you to fold that piece of paper, put it in one of the envelopes and seal it. And the ushers are going to pass the offering plates around. We're going to put those envelopes in the offering plate. And I got a trash can up here someplace. We're going to deposit those in the trash can. And then I'm going to take them out after the services and I'm going to burn them. And the reason that I'm going to burn them is that it's a sign of that promise that the psalmist makes, that When we seek God's forgiveness, God takes our sins and removes them as far away as the east is from the west. They are gone. Now, I thought about processing everybody out there for the burning of these things, but today kind of prevents that. You're welcome to join me if you want, but I certainly won't insist on that. So, one more time. I invite you to write on those blue pieces of paper those things about the last year that you want to leave behind. For what do you seek forgiveness? Where are the broken places of your life where you seek healing? What do you want to leave behind as you walk across the threshold into a new year? So we'll take 3 or 4 minutes for that.